हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज नीता शेट्टी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, AJIT मैंगलोर. सो इन टुडे सेशन विल बी डिस्कसिंग द लैब प्रोग्राम 8 फ्रॉम लैबोरेटरी SSOS. सो SSOS सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर एंड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम लैबोरेटरी एंड द सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 17CSL67. So today we are discussing the 8th lab program. It is systems, it is operating system lab program. So I already told in my previous session. So in this laboratory there are 9 programs. Out of 9 programs, first 6 programs are system software programs, and remaining 3 programs, that is lab program 7, lab program 8, and lab program 9 are operating system program. So in lab program 8 we'll see the question. The question is, design, develop and implement C or C++ or Java program to implement Banker's algorithm and assume suitable input required to demonstrate the result. So lab program 8 is to implement Banker's algorithm. So before going to the program, so let's discuss the theory part. So first, what is Banker's algorithm? So first I'll explain the theory part, then I'll go for the output, okay, I mean the program part. So now, what is Banker's algorithm? So the Banker's algorithm is known as deadlock avoidance algorithm. Banker's algorithm is also known as deadlock avoidance algorithm. That means, so this algorithm, Banker's algorithm, is framed to avoid the deadlock. Now, what is deadlock? So deadlock, it is a major problem in a computer. Okay, so deadlock is a major problem. So how can I define deadlock? So deadlock is a, it is a condition or situation when two processes sharing the same resources are effectively preventing each other from accessing the resources. Okay, so that is known as deadlock, and we'll be studying this deadlock concept in the operating system subject. So what are the different conditions for the deadlock? Okay, when the deadlock will occur? So the deadlock usually occur when there is a mutual exclusion or when there is a hold and wastage. That means a process will be holding one resources and waiting for another resources, or when there is a no preemption. That means even though process has completed the execution, it won't free up its resources. Or sometimes circular wait. Circular means A is waiting for B, or process B is waiting for C. Okay, so that time we call it as a loop, or it is a circular wait. So these are the different situation when the deadlock will occur, and we'll be studying this concept in the operating system concept. So I'm not going in detail. Okay, so here I'll be explaining the Banker's algorithm. Okay, so this algorithm, first let me see what are the input for this algorithm. So the assume, consider an example, later I'll explain the algorithm. Okay, so consider a system with the 5 process P0 to P4 and 3 resource of type A, B, C. Okay, so here the Banker's algorithm, how it works is, so first it will assume the maximum instance. Okay, so in Banker's algorithm, so each process must declare the maximum number of resources that it may need. Okay, then this algorithm dynamically examines the resource allocation that can never be a circular wait condition. So what, how this algorithm will work is, so first it will assume what are the maximum instance for each resources. So first this algorithm takes input, how many resources? So here they given there are 3 resources A, B, C, and how many process? There are 5 process, that is process P0, P1, P2, P3 and P4. So there are 5 process and there are 3 resource, and the name of the resource are A, B and C. Now the each resource, they are given the maximum instance. Okay, so maximum instance for each resource is, for resource A the instance is 10, for resource B maximum instance is 5, and for resource C maximum instance is 7. Okay, so they given there are 3 instance A, B, C, and that is 10, 5 and 7. So now this are the process. Here you can see in the table, here the process are P0, P1, P2, P3 and P4. So what is the input? First, I told these are the input number of process, number of resource and maximum instance. After that, we need to read two matrices. Okay, we need to read two matrix. They are known as allocation matrix and maximum matrix. Okay, it is also known as allocation matrix and maximum matrix. So for allocation matrix, so there are three instance A, B, C. So we need to read the value for P0. For A, what is the allocation matrix, value of allocation matrix? For B, what is the matrix? And for C, what is the matrix? Okay, so similarly for P1, we need to take the value. Okay, so here I take an example, it is 200. For P2, it is 302. For P3, it is 211. For P4, it is 002. So this is the input I need to take for this algorithm. Similarly, we need to read two matrices, that is the maximum matrices. They are I have taken for P0, ABC 753. For P1, it is 322. For P2, it is 902. For P3, it is 222. And for P4, it is 433. Okay, so what is the input together? Input first, how many number of process, how many resources, and what is the maximum value of each resources, and we need to read the matrix. There are two matrix I told, there are, that is allocation matrix and maximum matrix. Okay, so let me first we'll see how the what is the logic behind the algorithm. So this is a logic. Okay, so there are four steps. So first we should see, let work and finish be vectors of length m and n respectively. So initially work is equal to available. Okay, so we call the available matrix. So this available matrix, later I'll tell you how to calculate this. So we call this available matrix as work matrix. Okay, we call this available matrix as work matrix. So I can say it is a work matrix, or we call it as an available matrix. So first we need to calculate the value of available matrix. So how to calculate the value of available matrix? So how to calculate is, first what you need to do is, you need to calculate the summation of allocation matrix. So you need to calculate the sum of this allocation matrix. So here in allocation matrix A, B, C, and these are the values you have taken. So what is the summation of A? So you add this A matrix value, there is 2 plus 3 plus 2, it is 7. So here it is 1 plus 0 plus 1, so it is 2, and this is 3. Okay, so what is the value here? It is 7, 2 and 3, right? 7, 2 and 3. Okay, now what is the maximum instance? Maximum instance are this is 7, 2 and not 3, it is 5. Okay, so summation of A is 7, summation of B is 2, summation of C is 5, right? 2 plus 1 plus 2, 5. Okay, so this is a summation of allocation matrix. Okay, now what is the maximum instance given for each resource? That is 10, 5, 7. So you can see here, what I've done is, I've taken 10, 5, 7 minus 7, 2, 5. Okay, so how to calculate the initial available matrix, or it is also known as work matrix? Summation of this, and here we are taking maximum instance. So maximum instance minus total allocation, that is 10, 5, 7 is a maximum instance minus what's the total allocation? It is a 7, 2, 5. So when you divide, when you subtract 10 by 7, 10 minus 7 is 3. You are getting this value is 3. Now 5 minus 2 is 3 and 7 minus 5 is 2. So this is the initial available matrix. So how to calculate the initial available matrix? That is maximum instance minus the summation of allocation matrix. Summation of allocation means it is 10, 5, 7 minus 7, 2, 5. So 10 minus 7 you will get 3, 5 minus 2 you will get 3, 7 minus 5 you will get 3. So this we call it as an available matrix. So initially calculate the available matrix. So initially calculate the available matrix, and we call it as an work is equal to available matrix. Okay, next. If it is finisher for, okay, that means it is not over. We are in start from the process 0. We need to check the condition whether need matrix is less than work. Okay, we should check the value whether need matrix is less than work. So now, what is that need matrix? So you can see here the value of need matrix, right? So need matrix, now how to calculate the need matrix? So need matrix is calculated as maximum matrix minus allocation matrix. Okay, so how to calculate the need matrix? So need matrix, so you can see the here, need matrix is calculated as maximum maximum matrix minus allocation matrix. Okay, so need matrix is calculated as maximum matrix minus allocation matrix. So how to calculate it? So 7 minus 0 is 7, 5 minus 1 4, 3 minus 0 3. 3 minus 2 is 1, 2 minus 0 is 2, 2 minus 0 is 2. Next, 9 minus 3 is 6, 0 minus 0 is 2, 2 minus 2 is 0. Next, 2 minus 2 is 0, 2 minus 1 is 1, 2 minus 1 is 1. Here, 4 minus 0 is 0, 3 minus 0 is 0, 3 minus 2 is 1. Okay, so this is how we are calculating the need matrix. Okay, so calculate the need matrix. First you need to calculate the work matrix, that we call it as an available matrix. Then go for the calculation of need matrix. And how to calculate need matrix? Maximum matrix minus allocation matrix. Okay, so next what you need to do is you need to check the condition whether need is less than or equal to work. Okay, we need to check the condition whether need matrix is less than or equal to work. Okay, so you can see here, initially I'm checking whether 743 is less than or equal to work matrix. That means you should check for the each resource, for each instance, whether 7 is less than 3. Okay, no. 4 is less than 3, no. And 3 is less than 2, no. Okay, so if any one condition fails, then entire condition is wrong. Okay, so we need to check the condition whether need matrix is less than available matrix. Okay, so you can see here we are checking the condition whether mean matrix is less than or equal to work. Okay, so if it is true, come for the next step. What you need to do is you need to check the you need to update work matrix. Work is equal to work plus allocation. Okay, so if it is true, then you need to update work is equal to work plus allocation. So if it is false, go to fourth step, finish step. Okay, so otherwise work is equal to work plus allocation, again go to step 2. So that means I'll trace for this example here. So these are the input are taken here. Allocation matrix are taken input, maximum matrix are taken input, and I calculate the initial available matrix and also I calculate the need matrix. Okay, now let me apply the logic here. So what is my logic? I need to check first. I'll start from P0. I'm checking whether need matrix is less than work matrix. So whether 743 is less than 332, no. If it is no, go to next step. Okay, so next step is next process, P1. Okay, so P1. So what is P1? 1, 2, 2. Whether 1, 2, 2 is less than 3, 3, 2 is 1 is less than 3, 2 is less than 3, and 2 is less than or equal. It is not only less than, it is less than or equal. You can see here less than or equal. So the condition is true. If the what is condition true means you need to update the work matrix. So work matrix becomes work plus allocation. So work matrix becomes work plus allocation. So what is work matrix? It is 3, 3, 2 plus what is allocation matrix? I mean process P1. So what is a P1 allocation matrix value? 2, 0, 0. So 3 plus 2, 5. 3 plus 0, 0, 2 plus. So it is 5, 3, 2. So you can see here, given here, updated available matrix is how much? It is 5, 3, 2. Updated available matrix is 5, 3, 2. You can see here, updated available matrix is 5, 3, 2. Okay, now I completed with the P1. So you can see here, this is output. I'm not allowing P0 to execute first. If I allow P0, what happens? There is a chance of deadlock. So I'm not allowing P0 to execute first. I'm allowing P1 to execute. Okay. So now what is our available matrix or work matrix? It is 5, 3, 2. So next process, that is 6, 0, 0. Now check whether 6, 0, 0 is less than 5, 3, 2. No, condition is failed, right? Condition is wrong. So don't execute P2. Okay, if you execute P2, what happens? It is not a safe state. Okay, so it becomes an unsafe state. Unsafe means where there is a deadlock. Safe means there is no deadlock. So if I allow P2, there is a chance of deadlock. So I'm not allowing P2. So you can see here, after P1, I'm not putting P2. Okay, because if I put P2, there is a chance of deadlock. Okay, so what is next step? Take another process, that is 0, 0, 0, 1. Whether 011 is less than 532? Yes. If yes, we need to update the available matrix. How? So 532 plus, you are in P3, right? So take the allocation matrix of P3, 211. So 211 plus 532. So 2 plus 5 is 7. 1 plus 3 is 4. 1 plus 2 is 3. So your available matrix got updated into 743. Your available matrix got updated into 743. Am I right? Okay, next. Now you completed P3, so you can allow the P3 to execute. After P1, you are allowing P3 to execute. Okay, now next step is P4. Next step is P4. So what is P4? 431. Whether 431 is less than 743? Whether 431 is less than 743? Yes. If yes, you need to update this 743. So 743 plus P4's allocation 002. So 0 plus 77, 0 plus 44, 2 plus 3 is 5. So your available matrix got updated to 745. Your available matrix got updated into 745. Okay, now so you are allowing P5 to so this is P1, P3. So next is P4. Okay, so here actually there is no P5. Okay, sorry, here there is no P5. I'll change it. So because our number of processes from P0 to P1, okay, so it is P4. Okay, so next okay, I'll go to that step. So next, after P1, P3 and P4. Okay, so we complete a process P1, process P3 and process P4. Okay, now which two processes pending? P0 and P2. So go back to P0. So calculate the need matrix. So what is need matrix now? It's already calculated 743. When the 743 is less than 745, say 7 is less than or equal to 7. Yes, 4 is less than or equal to yes. 3 is less than or yes. So if yes, we need to update this. Okay, so 745 plus allocation matrix of P0010. So your available matrix becomes, it is 755. Available matrix is 755. So now it is 755, which is one more process. So you can allow P0 to execute, which is one more process. It is P2. It is 600. So 600 is less than 755. Yes, if yes, update the 755. 755 becomes plus 302. 7 plus 3 is 10. 5 plus 0 is 5, and 5 plus 2 is 7. So 1057. So we allow, we execute all the process in which order? First you allow P1 to execute, next you allow P3 to execute, then P4, then P0, then P2. So this how we got this sequence? Because of Banker's algorithm. So what is the main idea behind Banker's algorithm? What is the main logic behind Banker's algorithm? So Banker's algorithm says that if need is less than equal to available, then update work is equal to work plus allocation. If this condition fails, then take the next process. So that is the algorithm they told. If need is less than or equal to, okay, then work is equal to, we'll go for step 3. Otherwise, go for step 4. Finish. That means in case next process, they take next process. Okay, we call this as a safe state. Okay, safe state means because of Banker's algorithm, we got this state as safe state. Okay, so this is a main logic for this program, Banker's algorithm. So now let's look at the output for the program. Then we can go for the program. So what is output? So first it will ask, enter the number of resources. So let me show the output for the same problem which I explained here. So, and what is enter the number of resources? It is 3. And enter the maximum instance of each resource. For A is 10, B is 5, C is 7. Enter the number of process. Enter the number of process, that is 5. And enter the allocation matrix. So you can see here how we are getting the output in this order. So it should print A, B, C, and it should print P0 to P4. Then you are reading the input using two for loop. So these are the input you are reading. And again, you are reading the maximum matrix. To find it, it will print the sequence P1, P3. So here it is, no P5 is not there. So it is P4. Okay, sorry, here P5 is not there because we are having only from P0 to P4. So there is no P5. Okay, so here, okay, so this is the output. So let's go to the program first. Okay, so the, let's begin the program. So the main, okay, so hash include, just add that hash include str.h because this is a C program. Okay, please add the header file hash include str.h. Next we'll go for the void main. So here in main you can see, so these are the variables I am adding here. Okay, so okay. So void main. Next the local variables are int k equal to 0, Okay, so had the header file hash include str dot h next to void main. So these are the local variables k equal to these are the integer variables k equal to 0, and I'm taking an array output 10 because I need to store that process in the output array. Next, I want the variable d equal to 0, t equal to 0, and I need array instance 5. Okay, array size is 5, available that is 5, allocate matrix that is 2 array. You can see here 2 dimensional array, the size is 10 and 5. Then I need the neat matrix, the maximum matrix, and process number. So all these are the variables I need, and count equal to 0. Okay, so this is an integer variable. So next, to enter the number of resources. So let me take RZ is equal to 3. So you can see here, and now R0 becomes 3. Okay. Next, enter the maximum instance for each resource. Enter the maximum instance for each resource. Okay. So I'm taking for loop. What I'm doing is since avail AVAIL, it's an array. Okay. So initially it is 0, avail 0, 0. Next, I'm printing. Okay, percentage CI plus 97. So what is the ASCII value for which character? The ASCII value is 97 for A, right? Small letter A. Okay, so initial I is 0. So 0 plus 97. So it will print A. Okay, and you will read the instance value. So what is the initial instance value? It is 1057, right? So how it will print is, so you can see the output here, A equal to 10. Okay, that is I is 0. So 0 plus 97 A. Next, 1 plus 97, 98. 8, it is B. Next, 2 plus 97, it is C equal to 7. So it will print A, B, C value in this manner. Okay, so you can see here at the same time, avail 0 becomes 0, avail 1 becomes 1, avail 2 becomes 2, and it is printing A, B, C, and the 1057 is stored in the array INS instance 0, 10, instance 1, 5, and instance 2, 7. Okay, next, enter the number of process. So process number is equal to 5. Okay, enter the number of process, it is 5. Next, here you are reading the allocation matrix. Here you are reading the allocation matrix. So this is 2 dimensional array. So how to read the data into an array using two for loop. So you can see here, for I equal to 0, RZ is 3, right? So I less than 3, printf percentage, say again you are printing. Okay, so see here, enter the location to print, enter the location matrix, then it will print A, B, C. So you can see here it is printing A, B, C. Okay. So next for loop. It is reading the value. Okay. So for I equal to 0, I less than process number. So it is reading the value P0 is equal to. Okay, it is printing the value P of 0 is equal to I. Okay, so what is I? I is initially 0, right? So it is printing P of 0 is equal to 0. So you can see here it is printing P of 0. Okay, next, for j equal to 0, scanf percentage to allocation. What is I? I is 0, j is 0. So this is a 0, 0, this is 0, 1, this is 0, 2, this is 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2. So this is 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 0, 3, 1, 3, 2, and this 4, 0, 4, 1, 4, 2. Okay, so in the same value, it will store, it will read the values. Why? Because here j gets incremented. At the same time, it is calculating the value, that is it is finding the summation of allocation matrix. Okay, why we need the summation of allocation matrix? Why? Because, so how we are calculating this initial work matrix, we need the summation of allocation matrix, right? Summation of A, summation of B, summation of C, that is 7, 2, 5. So what you're doing is, so when you read the allocation matrix, at the same time you're calculating the summation of A, summation of B, and summation of C, and you're storing in avail 0, avail 1, avail 1. So how, at this, when you read the values, at the same time it is counting the value. So what's the meaning of avail j? Avail j plus is equal to allocated ij, means it is avail of j is equal to avail of j plus allocation ij. Okay, so it will read the value. Now again, I gets incremented, I becomes 1. So now it will print P of 1, it will read the values 2, 0, 0, and it will calculate avail matrix. Okay, again, it whether I is less than process number, now I becomes 2, so it will read the value 302, because j gets incremented from 1 to, because j is less than rz. So j can be 1, 0, 1, 2, and this can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Because process number is 5. So again I gets incremented, I becomes 3, j becomes 0, 1, it will read the value 2, 1, 1. So again I becomes 4, I becomes 4, 4 is less than process number 5. Yes, again it will read the value 1, so it will take 0, 0, 2. So at the same time it is calculating the summation of A, summation of B and summation of C. So summation of A will get S7, summation of B will get S2 and summation of C will get it as 5. Okay, so this is a code to print the allocation matrix. Okay, at the same time it is calculating the addition of A, addition of B and addition of C. Okay, so here what is the input? This program requires total number of process, total number of resource, maximum instance were taken, and it has read the allocation matrix. Next you should read the maximum matrix. Okay, so this is a code to print the to take the values for maximum matrix. So you can see here the maximum matrix it is reading. So same here, we're using for loop to print the value, enter the maximum matrix. So it will print enter the maximum matrix and it will print the value. It's 97, it is ASCII value ABC. So it will print P of 0, P of 1, P of 2, P of 3, P of 4. Okay, so it will add and it will calculate the avail matrix. It will update the avail matrix. So you are getting 3, 3, 2. So initial available matrix is also known as a work matrix. So how you are calculating the work matrix? Here you calculate a work matrix. How? Maximum instance minus total allocation. So here you can see here maximum instance minus total allocation. So instance 0, 1, 2 contains the value 10, 5, 7 and avail 0, 1, 2 previous level 0 contains 7, 2, 5. Okay, and this contains 10, 5, 7. So 10, 5, 7 minus 7, 2, 5 and it is updating avail matrix to 3, 3, 2. Okay, so at the same time it is calculating the initial available matrix or work matrix 3, 3, 2. Okay, and it is printing the maximum matrix. So again here P of initial it is P of 0 it will print, P of 1 it will print, P of 2, P of 3 and P of 4 and it is printing the, it is reading the value for maximum matrix. Okay, so maximum matrix is what it is 7, 5, 3. Next again I gets incremented, I becomes 1. Okay, here again j will scan from 0, 1, 2, so it will read the 3, 2, 2. Again I gets incremented, here j will go from 0 to 0, 1, 2, so it is 9, 0, 2. Again I gets incremented, so j 0, 1, 2, it is 4, 2, 2. Again I becomes 4, j becomes 0, 1, 2, so it will read the value 5, 3, 3. Okay, so this is how it is reading the matrix, available matrix and maximum matrix, then it will print the value. Okay, so now till here we have taken the input. So now we have what? We have what is the total number of resources, what is the total number of process, we have the work matrix, we have maximum matrix and we have allocation matrix. So next what we need to calculate, we need to check the condition. What's the main logic of the algorithm? We need to check the condition whether need matrix is less than available matrix. So first we need to calculate the need matrix, right? So here you can see here I'm taking a label A equal D equal to minus 1 because later I'll call this and I'll come to this part later. Okay, and I'm using for loop, I'm calculating the need matrix. So why? Because two for loop, again need matrix are two dimensional array, so I need to calculate to evaluate that I need two for loop. You can see here for I equal to 0, I less than process number, for j equal to 0, j less than, and I'm keeping the track of that count. So and initially t is equal to p0. Okay, so calculate the need matrix. So what is the need matrix? So what is the formula of need matrix? Need matrix is equal to maximum minus maximum matrix minus allocation matrix. So how we are calculating need matrix? Maximum matrix minus allocation matrix, right? 7, 5, 3 minus 0, 1, 0, you're getting 7, 4, 3. 3, 2, 2 minus 2, 0, you're getting 1, 2, 2. 9, 0, 2 minus 3, 0, 2, you're getting 6, 0, 0. 2, 2, 2 minus 2, 1, 1, you're getting 0, 1, 1. 4, 3, 3 minus 0, 0, 2, you're getting 4, 3, 1, right? So what is the formula of need matrix? Need matrix is equal to maximum matrix minus allocation matrix. You're getting the value of need matrix. Okay, now what is the main logic, what condition we are checking? If need matrix is less than available matrix, if need matrix is less than available matrix, if this condition is true, then increment the count. Okay, increment the count, and at the same time if count equal to 3, Okay, calculate the available matrix. Available matrix is equal to available plus allocation. Okay, we are updating the available matrix. Available matrix is equal to available plus allocation. Okay, so and you are printing this process number into the output array. Why? Because here once P1 completes his work, you need to you are printing in P1 in output array. Next P, you are not printing P2 because it is not satisfying the condition. Right? P3. Next P4. Then P0. Then P2. So similarly in the program I'm showing here, so output is equal to P of I and it is updating available matrix. Okay, if this condition is not true, okay, next you're taking next process to P++ is PI. So here you'll complete that P1, P3, then P4. So once again you should go back to that P0 and P1, right? So once again you're calling that label with the label is d = -1. If d is not equal to -1, so again take the process number, okay, go to A, okay, again come back, again calculate the need matrix and print the output array. So finally in the output screen, okay, as here you're storing the data into the output array, final output screen will print the array, okay, output array as like this: P1, P3, P4, P0 and P2. So this is a program. So simple, here all till here we are taking the input, the logic is just this part. Okay, if need is less than and then you are updating work matrix and printing the value in the output array. Okay, thank you.